two, one, two, three, four. On the road again. Just can't wait to get on the road again.
Hello, everybody, and welcome back to the channel. John Fix and I are sure glad to see you today. Today we found another perfect handle screwdriver we've never had before. Really unusual item. We'd like to show it to you, tell you about it, and do a restoration today. So let's get on down to the shop and get started.
Let me start off this presentation by showing you an item unrelated to what I'm going to cover today, and that is this beautiful drain plug wrench that was restored by Big Vic. And he restored it, did a beautiful job on it. It was a total mess. And then he sent it to me because it was a Tremo, and he knew I, you know, loved and collected Tremo tools. And I recently did a video on another Tremont tool that I restored. Then I showed my whole collection off, and I left this tool out. The reason I left it out is I've got several tool cabinets with drawers full of tools that I restored that aren't on my wall. And I have one marked miscellaneous because this didn't really fit my normal wrench and screwdriver and plier type category. I've got them in the drawers by category, so I overlooked it, and just guess I got so many tools I don't know what I have. So I apologize to Big Vic. I do enjoy the tool. It was a really nice tool, and it was super you to restore it and send it to me. Sorry I left it out of the video. What I am covering today is a screwdriver I've never had in my collection before, and if it looks a little familiar, there's some reasons why. This is a J.J. Ryan, made by J.J. Ryan Tool Works, and I just acquired it. I haven't had one in all these years of collecting screwdrivers, but the familiarities are for a reason. John Ryan was a machinist who worked for the Clark Bolt Company, and he was making forging heads on and to create steel, you know, bolts, forging the bolt heads on them. And he went into business with a partner in 1914 to make screwdrivers primarily, and a brick chisel, which was a main item for him, and later expanded out into all types of a big broad range of screwdrivers, chisels, punches, and that's primarily what he made for many, many, many years. But in 1930, after the H.D. Smith Perfect Handle Company went bankrupt, all my information in the past said that Tremont took over that operation. And you later on saw some tools made, wrenches made, with the perfect handles on them. But what I've got now for information is that the screwdriver, maybe they just took over the screwdriver part, but J.J. Ryan Tool Company started making the perfect handle screwdriver. And you'll see the influence on the handles here, and also on the total screwdriver, with the screwdriver plus a shank going all the way through the head, just like the perfect handle. And they did use a larger rivet on it here. But then added this little area here for turning the wrench, by turning the screwdriver where you could put a wrench on it and turn it. So you saw the influence of the perfect handle. So that's how they started making this design, and I had no idea until I did some research recently and found out that they did take over the screwdriver operation. The company was actually located in Southington, Connecticut, and Plantsville, Connecticut, and where Peck Stowe and Wilcox tools were made, and also the H.D. Smith Perfect Handle Company was also located in Plantsville. So that's, you know, they were in close proximity to all of them. And in addition to their many screwdrivers, here are some of the products that J.J. Ryan manufactured. The first thing I did to this tool was just cleaned up on the shank portion of it with a piece of real fine steel wool because I wanted to bring out the name on here. And it's really tiny print and hard to read. I don't know how well you'll be able to see it here. See if this thing gets into focus. But it says J.J. Ryan Tool Works in Southington, which is Southington, Connecticut. And a real tiny little print on here. And I wanted to get that exposed so when I am working on finishing this tool that I pay particular attention not to erase that I've done on tools in the past, which would be easy to do with a real light, tiny print. Also on this tool, one thing that one owner did along the way was decided to make a real fine, narrow tip on here, and he did it by just filing off the end of it here, putting a bevel on the end of the screwdriver. That's a big no-no. So instead of tapering it on down and leaving that intact, he put that bad. And he even did a lousy job on this one, just off to the side. He was just trying to get something done, I guess, and bang, hit it on a grinding wheel on both sides and didn't even do that very carefully. So we're going to reprofile this tip to get it in good shape, clean up the metal all the way around. You can see how it's chattered around the sides here and on the end. And so that'll have to be cleaned up. The wood is in really good shape. It needs to be refinished, of course, and along with the rivets. So, well, this will be a nice looking little tool once it's finished. I just wanted to show you what we were starting with, and now we'll take it down and show you what we can do with it. Well, here we are with a couple more steps done. We've cleaned the metal up all the way around and then scraped and sanded the handles on here. It's got some nice wood on here. We don't use a final finish on the metal yet. I mean, we'll wax it or shine it, but we'll basically just wax it. But I don't do that till I've completely refinished the wood, because anything you get on the wood is just going to keep the stain from working right and the finish on it from looking right. So next step is to put the stain on the wood and then give it a final going over with a wax to protect it and bring out everything on here and make it look just right. So next will be the stain. I've been asked about applying stain. I've seen a lot of people take a rag and wipe the stain on here. But what I do is, other than the bottom that I mask off, it's impossible to... Yeah, it's possible, but a big job to try to mask off these areas. So I just take a real steady hand, I get my stain, and actually just paint it on here. And try my best to keep it off the metal. That's how I apply it. And then after I get the first coat on here, I let it sink in just a little, and then I go over it again and make sure there's no areas where it's absorbing or not absorbing. And as soon as I get all the stain on here, then I take a Q-tip, dampen it with mineral spirits and go over all the metal. Be sure I wipe off any stain that might have gotten on there. So that's how I apply stain. It's probably a little more tedious, but it's worked well for me. And some people don't have that steady of a hand to work around like that. I seem to be able to do that pretty well. So that's how I do it. Okay, we'll go back to the beginning on this J.J. Ryan Perfect Handle screwdriver. Call it the Perfect Handle because they did take over the Perfect Handle operations in 1930, the screwdriver portion of it, when H.D. Smith went bankrupt. And they started making this screwdriver. Before that, they had primarily made chisels, brick chisel being one of their big items, and they made chisels, punches, and some awls, some related items, and then they got into screwdrivers, and this came about, you know, from the purchase of the Perfect Handle Group. So you can see what it was, and now I will show you what it is. There it is done. I think we got a nice improvement. We'll tell you what we did. We'll start with the handle. You can see the Perfect Handle shape and influence on here, except for the large rivets, which I think was an improvement over the Perfect Handle. It had a really small rivet in it, and the large one, really, to me, it looks nice and should, and basically does a more effective job than that little tiny rivet. What's different about this screwdriver is the flats they put on the shank portion of it here, where you could get a wrench on it to get added torque. The metal, completely refinished and smooth. You can barely read J.J. Ryan Tool Works on here. It's very tiny print, but I kept it on there just like it was when I got it. I didn't wear any of that away. I was very careful with it so it would maintain integrity of it. The shank was in good straight shape on this, unlike some screwdrivers, so it didn't have to do anything there. But we did take the tip and got that milled down and sanded down, filed down. Got it profiled back in shape. You can see it's still not in a very wide one. I did get it somewhat, but every time I did that, it shortened it a little. So I just took a bare minimum amount off that I needed to make it look right with the profile corrected on here. So it's a beautiful screwdriver. Beautiful. Delighted to have it in my collection. I'm going to show you an interesting fact here. I mentioned their neighbors were the Pexo Tool Company. And I'll show you a Pexo screwdriver here. You can see it. Now, to me, where to lay straight. To me, it looks like the Pexo people walked over to the Ryan plant and said, make me a screwdriver. I don't know it for sure because none of their information tells who made tools for them, but except for the rounded shape compared to the oval shape, everything's the same, the metal all the way down the tool, the square or the flats added to the shank here and the large rivets. To me, that is comes out of the same factory. It's got to be. I know I'm speculating here, but I just don't see it any other way. Here's another Pexo screwdriver, and you can see just a larger one, but made the same way. So I would assume that Ryan made these screwdrivers being neighbors. Just speculation on my part, but it just seems that way. Both are great screwdrivers, being the flattened more oval shape. This does more resemble the perfect handle, where this kind of takes on a little distinction of its own with the round handle here. Can't say really one any better than the other, just a matter of what they wanted and choice on it. It's J.J. Ryan, delighted to have them in my collection. Another perfect handle. I hope you enjoyed the video.